My name is Stacy Rolfe, and my husband and I own this property. We bought it in 2013 and started developing it from raw land. Wild Horse Creek Road has been home to us and my kids forever. It's been where they've grown up. So we knew we didn't want to leave the area, but some land would have been nice. So we were very fortunate to be able to get this property. Kind of the story behind R&R Ranch is it stands for Rothberg and Rolfe. We like to blend both families together. Both of our parents were very strong, influential people in our lives. So we feel like that is definitely a homage to both of our parents. And then the kids played around and developed a logo. We started from there doing the land development. Then we built the house first. Once we were in the house, the barn was under construction. That was finished in May of 2016. And then we did Dave's garage and finished with the feed barn. And I should say we also added the bridge, because the bridge was an integral part of this overall plan when we sat down with our builder. So the bridge was quite an undertaking, but we have it. I love it. It's beautiful. Our horses have not been rescued by us in the sense that we did not find them faltering along the road or pick them up from a pile, a heap, and rescue them. We didn't do that. But we have taken them out of some pretty bad situations, and we have given them a much better life. My daughter Belle had said that, Mom, it would be fun if we had a miniature horse. She actually started looking, and we found two on Craigslist, of all places. They were from about 6 hours away, so the owner brought them in. Very nice person, but was she giving them a great life? No, she wasn't. And the bigger part of that picture is that when we got them, they were 2 years old, and we were their fourth owner. So they had no consistency. They had nothing in their lives that really created a great life. And things just kind of literally grew from there. The day-to-day tasks are pretty time-consuming. Our mornings here start at 5:30. That's when the horses get their first hay for the day, and then they get their stalls cleaned. Pretty much by the time they have finished or nearly finished their hay, then it's breakfast time around 8 o'clock or 8:15. Once they finish breakfast, they are turned out. All of our minis go in what's called a dry lot, so they have paddocks where there's no grass, and they go outside and they play, and they stay outside depending on the weather. Generally speaking, for half the day. So they'll come in at 1 o'clock, and then from 1 until 4, it's a Spanish siesta out there. I mean, just everybody goes to sleep. And then they get fed about 4:30 every day. Stalls are cleaned again, and they receive their last flake of the day at 7 o'clock, and lights out. Belle's my daughter. She's 23 years old, graduated from Old Miss last year, and she is now doing real estate, so that gives her a pretty flexible schedule. And I'm grateful for the time that she's here and she's not moved away, because Belle is our equestrian. She's how we got into all of this. She's been riding horses since she was 7, and she now competes all over the country. And Belle has really become the quote-unquote co-manager of this barn. Emma and Chloe both have very different needs than everybody else. They're my girls that I always have to try to make myself not cry when I talk about either one of them. Em was the mare that we got off of auction, and she was 10 years old at the time. And she was just this wonderful, sweet little mare. But she wasn't gaining any weight. She was very thin. So she had to go in for dental surgery. She actually had to have several teeth pulled. And then it was at that time, the vet, when he called to tell me how she did, he also said, well, you know, this pony's blind. She has something that's called moon blindness. And over time, whatever sight Emma did have deteriorated over time. And it has gotten to the point where she may be able to see shadows, but she gets around really well. She knows her stall, she knows where the water is, her food. We know how to warn her as we're taking her outside. There's a step out of the barn. We say, step, Em, and she steps down. Em's a special soul in this barn. Chloe is the other one. Chloe came from the Humane Society. She was picked up from their animal cruelty department, and she was in terrible shape when she came in. Her feet, if you can imagine, looked like an elf's shoe, where they were long and they curled up. And she was a terrible neglect case. And once we were able to adopt her, we brought her home. Chloe has many metabolic issues, and she's got Cushing's disease, she's insulin resistant, she has chronic laminitis, so her feet are almost always painful to her. We try to keep her as managed as we can. She takes 32 pills a day, and there's sometimes that she has to stay in her stall for days, weeks, and sometimes months at a time. And it is heartbreaking that she can't go outside and play with everyone else, but for her own health, we have to adjust how she is. She stays inside, we reduce her food, we soak her hay, we do all these things to try to get her built back up to where she can feel better, walk better, be pain-free. I think that we have given Chloe a longer life than anyone certainly would. Most people don't want to deal with those kind of issues. She's worth every dime. You know, the garage is Dave's thing. He loves cars, and who am I to deny his passion? He started collecting cars years ago. He likes old cars. He likes vintage cars, muscle cars. He likes just about anything, but his garage is his downtime. It's his time to just kind of exhale from his job. That's his love.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
We've always held on to this belief that when we built this property, it was going to be something special to us. But I also wanted it to be special to other people, and I wanted people to enjoy it. If anyone wants to come over and see the horses, call me. We welcome everybody, and that's a nice way to live.
What a wonderful world.